Hey guys, I just wanted to share a little pattern that I tie up. Super easy, super quick, and with the minimum of materials. It's a small damselfly pattern, and it works really well in the ponds and lakes in Florida. Generally tie them up in size 10 to 16. Most of the time I'm fishing 10s, 12s, and 14s. So I just wanted to share it with you. Here we go. Right now I've got a size 10 Aberdeen hook on. It's just a cheap Eagle Claw hook. Super inexpensive. You can get them at Walmart, Gander Mountain, probably anywhere that you can buy tackle. And on that hook I have a Cyclops bead, 3/32, already set up there. So I'm going to go ahead and tie in, starting with a chartreuse 6/0 thread. Just go ahead and lock our bead in place. We'll go ahead and snip our excess. Just continue to wind down the shank of the hook. And I'm basically going to take that all the way down to about the bottom on this hook and start working my way back up. Way back up to the bead. And what we're going to do is build a bit of a taper here. So we're going to take the thread back and we're going to stop just before where we did the last time and take the thread back up. And we're going to repeat this several times to kind of build a nice taper on the body. So once again, all the way back, not quite to where you ended the last time. All the way back up to the bead. By the time you're done with this, the bead is really stuck in place, which is nice. Using pretty loose wraps here, you don't have to go nuts. This is a super easy fly to tie. Up maybe two or three more times, about halfway there. So you can see that we have a nice kind of natural taper there. once you're done building the taper, just go ahead and bring your thread all the way back. I usually like to do tight wraps here just to keep it nice and clean. Bring it all the way back. All the way back down to just about the barb, about where you started. And we get a real nice tapered thread base. Now what we're going to do is to, just take a marabou feather. Great thing about this fly is it doesn't require anything other than a marabou feather, thread, a bead, and a hook. And with one marabou feather, you can actually tie quite a few of these little guys. So I've got a leftover marabou feather here, and if you see, I've got kind of a long piece here. This is all we're going to use today, and probably on this side, there's enough to tie another two flies. So we're going to take this bit of marabou here, the longer part, pinch it in between our fingers, and just leave a small amount out to build a tail with. And set that right on top of the hook. Just pinch it on. And then capture it with two or three good wraps. A nice tail. Maybe four there. And pull up your marabou. Lock two or three in front. And go ahead and advance your thread forward. this point we're going to take kind of our stem of Marabou here and use it as a handle, and we're actually going to pull the fiber up and give it a slight twist. So we start with a very thin wrap of Marabou. It'll help with the taper. And as we continue to wrap, the natural taper in the Marabou feather will kind of fatten up our body. And take him all the way up. You can see it kind of build that fatter body as we move up towards the bead. And I'll usually give it a good wrap or two right by the bead. And then just trap that in with your thread. Three good wraps, front and back, and then three in front. And then we will trim the Marabou. And then just give it a quick whip finish right behind the bead. And trim off our thread. And that's basically it. You can stop here. It's got a nice taper on it. A little puffy at the front, so I may trim it up. I just use a curved pair of scissors here to kind of create a little bit more of a taper. And this is a great fly for panfish, crappie, sunfish. I'll just grab a little tag there. Crappie, sunfish, bluegill, in ponds, retention ponds, and lakes in Florida. This is really well. You can give this to your kids, have them chuck this out there and they'll pull in a fish, seems like every other cast. Really successful fly pattern for me in the chartreuse color. I've tied it in brown and olives as well and had some decent success, but I think chartreuse is the favorite.